Now we will discuss a phenomenon called as coronary steel phenomenon. Now to understand this phenomenon, first we will discuss a basic thing. Suppose this is some portion of the heart which is supplied by coronary artery. This is main coronary artery. Coronary artery divide in branches, which further divide in branches. In most of the patient of classical angina, there is obstruction in the small branches of coronary artery. So the blood which is in this area is receiving, it decreases. So this lead to ischemia in this area, and that is the main cause of problem in angina. But the problem is, obstruction is present always, 24 hours. But patient of angina do not have pain 24 hours. Then why it is so? The reason is, our body has compensatory ability for everything. That means, whenever the ischemia occurs here, there is compensatory vasodilation. So that means, due to ischemia, this blood vessel, this will dilate. This blood vessel dilate, and it can, dilatation is so much that the effective diameter through which blood is going just become equal to a normal blood vessel. So it can receive the same amount of blood which a normal vessel is receiving. So this person do not develop any pain. Then we developed a drug called dipyridamole. This is a drug which dilate only small vessels. We have problem in small vessels. So we developed a drug which dilate only small vessels, thinking that it will be a very good drug for angina. But when we give dipyridamole, instead of decreasing the attacks of angina, the person started having more attacks of angina. Then the cause was searched, and it was found that it is dilating the small vessels only. So when we give dipyridamole, will it be able to dilate this vessel? Obviously not, because it is a large vessel. Similarly, it cannot dilate this vessel, but it can dilate this vessel. It is a small vessel. So when we give dipyridamole, dipyridamole lead to dilatation of the small vessel. So that means this vessel is dilated. So this vessel is remains same, but this vessel dilates. But dipyridamole try to dilate this vessel also. This is also small vessel, but it cannot be dilated because it is already dilated. Due to obstruction, it is already dilated. So what is the net effect of dipyridamole is, if 100 ml of blood is coming in this area, normally 50 ml was going to this area and 50 was going to this area. But on giving dipyridamole, the normal area become dilated, the ischemic area remains same. So more blood start going here and less blood comes here. So that means some of the blood from the ischemic area is stolen and given to normal area. That's why this is called coronary steel. Coronary steel means blood is stolen from the ischemic area and given to normally. So that lead to increase in attacks of angina, because ischemic area become more ischemic. So that means any drug which dilate only small vessels can show the phenomenon of coronary steel phenomenon. And these drugs you can remember from the mnemonic height, and you can logically think that if a person has stolen something, he will hide that thing. So the drugs are hide, H for hydralazine. I is isoflurane. D is dipyridamole. And E is enflurane. So these are the main drugs causing coronary steel phenomenon. Clear?